you know, we peace out in the podcast. Is there any story you have, like, with, you know, you don't have to say names or anything, you know, with like an individual client or somebody that you just seen perform in front of your, or like improve in front of your eyes that really kind of made your work feel worth it? Like, that really sticks out to you?
Yeah, definitely, man. I have a few. It's crazy because a lot of, you don't realize what people go through until you start meeting people. And with the business I'm in, people, a lot of people confide in you. A lot of people are vulnerable. Like, a lot of people in the gym are very vulnerable. So I have people who cry in front of me, who just break down and say, this is what's going on, you know? So I had a couple people who, I have people who are mute. I have a person who's mute that can't really speak, that I communicate with and I train with him. I have a young man that has autism. He's also, he can speak, but not as much. And they're doing great. But the people I have more, a bigger relationship with are these two women that I train. They just so happen to be vegan. Both of them are vegan. Yeah, so they started with me. And I remember, matter of fact, I'm just going to talk about one of them. They started with me when I was in Atlanta. And probably like a week or two in, she just broke down. Like, man, I can't do this. It's too heavy. It was like 15-pound weight. She was trying to do lunges. It was too heavy. This is, it's too much, blah, blah, blah. Long story short, the next couple months, she dropped 20 pounds. She toned up, got the muscle, and she literally hasn't missed a day since. I got to Atlanta in June. She hasn't missed a day since she first booked with me. So it's like, it's a lifestyle. People don't realize it's a lifestyle. It's not what you do, it's who you are. You're a YouTuber. That's who you are. You're a broadcaster. You do social media, basically. It's who you are. You don't look at it as a job. Oh, I gotta do this. Oh, I have to do this. I have to go to the gym. No, this is me. This is what I do. Yes, I'm at the gym. This is what I do. It's not what I have to do. So a lot of people need to look at it as a positive standpoint instead of a negative standpoint, because nobody wants to have to do something. They, you know what I'm saying? They would rather, you know, I'd rather do this. They don't want to have to do this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel you.
So, yeah, I guess you got to look at her lifestyle. She started looking at the lifestyle and literally has not missed a day since. And it's crazy. That's crazy to me. But, yeah, so that's – I'm so grateful for her. But, yeah, so she – yeah, that's one story I love. I'll tell over and over.
Tryna get that eighth badge, flamethrower, how we blaze tracks, straight facts, we gon' end up in that Maybach, speed racer on that racetrack, I'm just tryna get that eighth badge, flamethrower, how we blaze tracks, straight facts, we gon' end up in that Maybach, speed racer on that racetrack.